सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरि ओम। भगवद्गीता 17th चैप्टर। अर्जुन उवाच, ये शास्त्र विधिम उत्सृज्य यजन्ते श्रद्धयान्विताः तेषां निष्ठा तु का कृष्ण सत्वमाहो रजस्तमः। इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर, टुवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ द प्रीवियस चैप्टर, श्री कृष्णा पॉइंटेड आउट हाउ सम पीपल डू नॉट फॉलो द इंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑफ द वेदास एंड दे परफॉर्म सैक्रिफाइसेस just to fulfill their desires. Then he told Arjuna that there are three gates to hell, kama, krodha and lobha, and it is better to give up all these, and also it is good to perform all actions following the instructions of the Vedas. And so he instructed Arjuna to do that. Now Arjuna has a question. He says, Krishna, Arjuna uvacha, Arjuna said, Krishna, O Krishna, ye who shastra vidhim, the instructions of the Vedas, utsrujya, setting aside, shraddhaya, with shraddha, tu, but anvitaha, endued, yajante, perform sacrifice, tesham, their, nishtha, condition, ka, what, sattvam, sattva, rajas, rajaha, rajas, aho, or, tamaha, tamas. Aho means or. So, Arjuna is asking, people who perform sacrifice with shraddha, they are performing it with Shraddha, not without Shraddha, but they don't follow the scriptures. So it could be also the case of people who are either ignorant of the scriptural instructions, or they are lazy to follow the detailed instructions, or they are unable to follow them because it is very difficult to follow. So they worship the gods without following the Vedic instructions, but with Shraddha. That means they don't doubt Vedas. They believe in the Vedas, they have faith in the Vedas, but they are unable to follow it, or they are lazy, etc. What will happen to such people? What is their condition? Whether it is Sattva Guna, Rajas Guna or Tamo Guna? That is the question. Now here, the 17th chapter talks about the three kinds of Shraddha. That means Sattva, Rajas and Tamas are three Gunas. So Shraddha of people who are having these three Gunas. It is talking of these three Gunas, people who have these three Gunas. So Shraddha Traya Vibhaga Yoga. This chapter is called Shraddha Traya Vibhaga Yoga. Vibhaga means classification, yoga of classification of the three Shraddhas. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. In the second verse, Shri Krishna said, Trividha Bhavati Shraddha Dehinam Sa Swabhavaja Satviki Rajasi Chaiva Tamasi Cheti Tam Shrunu. Dehinam, of the embodied, that means one who has a body. Because of ignorance, one who has identified with a body, for that person, Satviki, the Satvika, Rajasi, Rajasika, Tamasi, the Tamasika, Cha, and Iti, thus, Trividha, threefold, means a group of three, or three kinds of eva indeed shraddha shraddha means what faith in the teacher guru and faith in the scriptures and above all faith in oneself shraddha bhavati is sa which swabhavaja inherent in their nature tam of it shrunu hear you hear so here Shri Krishna is telling that you see shraddha is of three kinds for people who have bodies shraddha is of three types and that is this shraddha is inherent in their nature that means shraddha is there in their nature because of their samskaras shraddha is there in the nature and the shraddha three kinds of shraddha what are they satvika rajasika and tamasika now I will tell about them you please hear he is telling to arjuna shri krishna is telling to arjuna three kinds of shraddha sattvanurupa sarvasya shraddha bhavati bharata shraddha mayoyam purusho yo yat shraddha sa eva sah bharata descendant of bharata king bharata belonging to the lineage of king bharata that is arjuna sarvasya of each person shraddha shraddha sattva anurupa is according to one's sattva means one's disposition one's mind and the samskaras that one has in one's mind bhavati is I am the purushah person purushah means here the person individual shraddha mayah consists of shraddha one shraddha yah that person yat shraddha what that person's shraddha is sah that person eva indeed sah that so that means you see everybody has shraddha according to one's natural disposition sattva means their condition of the mind and according to every person's shraddha an individual consists of one shraddha and whatever that person's shraddha is that person is that so whatever that person believes in that is what that person becomes so if a person has got satvika belief that person becomes satvika if someone has rajasika belief that person becomes rajasika if someone has tamasika beliefs that person becomes tamasika if somebody believes Shri Swami Vivekananda famously said if you believe you can if you believe you cannot so whatever you believe you become in the shastras or the scriptures also it is told whatever you believe you become so yajante satvika devan yaksha rakshansi rajasaha pretan bhuta ganansh chanye yajante tamasah janaha now shri krishna is talking about who are worshipped by satvika rajasika and tamasika people satvika devan yajante so the satvika people they worship devan devata rajasaha the rajasika they worship yaksha rakshansi they worship yakshas and rakshasas they worship yakshas and rakshasas and tamasaha tamasika people they worship pretas means ghosts bhuta ganan and also various hosts gana means groups of bhutas again bhuta pretas are all like ghosts goblins etc so they chaya jante they worship so satvika they worship gods rajasika they worship yaksha rakshasas and tamasika they worship ghosts and goblins then shri krishna says ashastra vihitam ghoram tapyante ye tapo janaha damba ahankara sanyuktaha कामराग बलान्विताः कर्षयन्तः शरीरस्थं भूत ग्रामम अचेतस माम चैवांत शरीरस्थम तान विद्धि आसुर निश्चयान. सो दीज आर ऑल द क्वालिटीज ऑफ असुरा, क्वालिटीज ऑफ द निश्चय और डिसीशन और द रिजॉल्व ऑफ ए असुरा आसुरिक रिजॉल्व. व्हाट इज दैट? दंभ अहंकार संयुक्ताः. रिजॉल्व और वाव, लाइक अ रेजोल्यूशन वाव ऑफ विच हैज गॉट दंभ. दंभ मीन्स शो ऑफ ऑस्टेंटेशन, अहंकार एंड ईगोटिज्म. सो इट इज संयुक्त, इट इज हैविंग बोथ शो ऑफ एंड ईगोइज्म. काम राग बलान्विता एंड इट इज एंडाउड विथ काम लस्ट, द बला ऑफ लस्ट एंड राग बला, द बलो ऑफ अटैचमेंट. सो काम राग बलान्विता एंड ये हु अचेतस सेंसलेस जनाः पीपल शरीरस्थम इन द बॉडी भूत ग्रामम ऑल द ऑर्गन्स डिफरेंट सेंस ऑर्गन्स अंत शरीरस्थम दैट आर इनसाइड द बॉडी माम मी च एंड कर्षयंत है टॉर्चर्स टॉर्चरिंग अशास्त्र विहितम नॉट टोल्ड बाय द शास्त्रस और द वेदास घोरम सिवियर तपह ऑस्टेरिटी तप्यंते प्रैक्टिस तान देम आसुर निश्चयान टू बी ऑफ आसुरिका रिजॉल्व विद्धि नो. सो द पीपल हु प्रैक्टिस सिवियर ऑस्टेरिटीज विच आर नॉट enjoined by the shastras, they are not told by the shastras or the scriptures or the Vedas, and they have egotism, they have show off and they have lust and attachment and they torture and they are senseless, they torture all the organs in the body. And they also torture me, Shri Krishna says, because I am dwelling in the body. So know them to be of Asurika resolve. Know them to be Asurika resolve, of Asurika resolve. Means this resolution, this decision is Asurika. It is Asurika, demonic. So why is it demonic? Because it is demonic because it gives pain to the body and the sense organs, and it is not prescribed in scriptures. So some people just want to show off that, see, I can do so much of austerity, I can stand on one leg for so much time. I want to show off that I can do austerity, and God says that I am also tortured inside, I am dwelling in the body within, inside body, internal body, I am also tortured. So torturing, not eating food for say many days, food, you don't consume any food for many days, you stay without proper clothes, like that, just torturing the body. Why? To show off one's strength. And so all this is of Asurika resolve, means these are all things done by a Asura. That is what Shri Krishna is telling. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.